off the deep end. I don't think you wanna go off the deep end. I don't think you wanna go off the deep end. I don't think you wanna give me a reason.
Great show, man.
Yo. What? You gonna?
We visited this exquisite bed and breakfast manor today. It was abandoned, of course, but the details from the ceiling to the floor were breathtaking. There was also some creepy parts. Supposedly, the manor is haunted. There was even a bridge inside. I've never seen that before. And there was a jail in the dungeon. So if you'd like to see the full video, link in bio.
So here's another story behind the photo. This is actually an abandoned high school auditorium in Detroit that caught fire in 2017. And this is what it used to look like before the fire. The architecture in this place is absolutely incredible. And even though the fire did do a lot of damage, you can still see the original architecture, which is just absolutely insane.
So since you guys enjoyed my first video, I'm posting another one about when I went to the minister's treehouse in Tennessee. And unfortunately, this place did burn down, so it's no longer there, but it was so sick when I went. It's like 7 or 8 stories and has really intricate rooms and floors, and it was super sick when I went. This bathtub was disgusting, and this was a view from the top, or at least almost the top.
Going up.
And here's one of my friends. I was just pulling her on this really cool swing that they had. Also, in the back we found an abandoned ambulance, which I thought was super cool.
This was one of the strangest experiences of our lives. Nara Dreamland was an abandoned theme park in the city of Nara, Japan. It was originally built as a replica of Disneyland. But when the actual Disneyland opened in Japan, they started to go out of business. It's been abandoned now since 2006 and was eventually demolished in 2016, just a few weeks after we snuck in to see it.
How is this for kids? Playboy 1999 calendar.
Mark, be careful!
We may have been the last people that ever got to explore it.
That you'll try to keep me safe. I think the owner died. Seriously. Oh, hey, it's okay. You know what? Sometimes when people are scared, they react by growling. He's just scared, so he's just growling. He's not really mean, I can tell. I can tell by his eyes. Come on. Come on. I'll bring you a new home. I can't, I already moved it earlier. Come on, you can tell, look at his eyes. He's not mean, he's just scared.
No, you didn't mean to bite me. Shit, good boy. We're at the vet's office. And, you got 8 more days, buddy. 8 more days. 8 more days. 8 more days and you're out. Yeah, he did. But that's why he's in quarantine. 8 more days. That's it. 8 more days.
So here's a quick story about what used to be the world's largest treehouse in Tennessee before it unfortunately burned down. It was built over the course of 14 years by a minister that wanted to build a place for anyone to come and feel welcome. This place is absolutely massive. It was 90 feet tall, 5 stories, and had over 80 different rooms. So we headed up this crazy spiral staircase and made our way into some of the rooms and found these crazy looking statues, which I'm not gonna lie, were a little bit creepy. There even was a room dedicated to what looked like it used to be an old church chapel. Then we made it all the way to the top into the bell tower, and it was just crazy to me that I was standing 90 feet up in a treehouse. And as much as I want this to be a happy ending, unfortunately the treehouse burned down in 2019, completely destroying it. So I'm glad I got a chance to document it while it was still standing.
Disneyland is your land.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Dad, stop! Dad, stop! Stop!
This crazy looking place is an abandoned zoo in Detroit, Michigan. It's one of the strangest places I've ever been. It's quite the journey to even get to this place. You go through tons of forest, what looks like Jurassic Park, before you finally get to the animal cages. And it's really fun in there, but some of the cages really look like they were supposed to have dinosaurs in them. And other ones look like this now. There's not much visibility there because everything is overgrown and abandoned, but eventually you find your way. I honestly can't even believe this place is real half the time. It's got such crazy architecture. It's definitely one of my favorite and the most unique places I've ever been while filming my documentary. The abandoned Belle Isle Zoo.
We just spotted the roller coaster from the advertisement sign.
Because the fog's taking in. It's like Silent Hill.
It's a freaking pirate ship.
Every ride is like a pirate ship that just went in circles.
It was all pirate themes.
Wild Nose, my favorite abandoned spot.
Okay, that's it. Okay, that's it. Oh, man.
Again, that merry-go-round. Now this little section with the green metal pipes looks like it has something to do with like a game. Maybe like you had to hit like the football into the hole, or maybe it was even like a golf, little golf course hit. I don't know. Circuit 2000, what is this? Did you like actually control a cart? Was it just completely for kids and it's like a little, very little kiddie ride?
This is an abandoned Chicago police station. I posted this months ago, but I wanted to come back and narrate it since there are so many interesting things about this place. My favorite part was all of this peeling paint. It literally looks like it's melting off the walls. It's crazy how this precinct left everything in place at this station. Mugshots and wanted posters were still on the walls. Almost everything was still in the station as if everybody suddenly left and never returned. It was sort of creepy. Mission boards were still intact with crimes and neighborhoods they were working on, mostly for drug sales. What's up with these wilted, sad-looking ceiling fans, though? The jail cells were actually really fun to explore. You just have to make sure not to mess around and close the door behind you. Otherwise, you're going to be calling the cops to come get you out, which will probably end us back up in jail once we get caught in there. Also, this building got really dark at times, which is kind of scary. This machine here was a fingerprint scanner. It makes me wonder why Chicago didn't try to sell a lot of this equipment, instead of just leaving it all here to rot. I would love to hear what you guys think about all this in the comments. I'll try to respond to as many as I can.
The doors too. That's creepy. See, it's on the front door too.
I know.